And then we also have from Bloomberg.com, Bank of America warning that markets are in a twilight zone and it's time to hold more cash and gold. let me just read for the listeners the note from Bank of America, and then I'll toss it your way, and then you can give us the whole rundown here. But this is what Bank of America sent out to their investors on May 18th. They said, quote, investors remain trapped in the twilight zone, the transition period between the end of QE and the first rate hike by the Fed, the start of policy normalization. Until A, the U.S. economy is unambiguously robust enough to allow the Fed to hike, and B, the Fed's exit from zero rates is seen not to cause either a market or macro shock, as it infamously did in 1936 or 37, the investment backdrop will likely continue to be cursed by mediocre returns, volatile trading rotation, correlation breakdowns, and flash crashes. For this reason, we continue to advocate higher than normal levels of cash, adding gold and owning volatility in mid-2015. Given extremities of liquidity, profits, technological disruption, regulation, income inequality, potential for a cleansing drop in asset prices cannot be dismissed. A whole lot of cleansing jargon there.
Cleansing drop.
Sounds,
how about losing
sounds
everything? How about losing your ass? How about mass hysteria? How about everything that has been built up off of this debt and death Ponzi scheme coming to a complete thermonuclear policy ash? That's what's coming to this. This is a completely unsustainable system. And geez, Bank of America saying to go buy gold. I mean, there's not enough gold in the world to hedge against this stuff. You know, we talked about Ray Dalio talking to the CFR, you know, getting laughed at for mentioning gold.
Do you own gold?
Oh, yeah. I do.
And he had to kind of defend himself like, no, this is the reason why. Here's Bank of America. People will say that no one saw this coming. We did. We've been calling it for years. And this is going to be the single largest event. You know, I really believe that this is going to be such a huge event that much in the same way that there was a BC and an AD, that humanity is going to change so dramatically, you know, after the dollar collapse. So maybe we'll call it DC dollar collapse or whatever going forward. That everything that's been popular and profitable and powerful in this paradigm will fail an utter mess and quickly too. I don't think people realize how quick the illusion of you know, the American pie dream will come to an end. How quickly you know, all these military bases all over the world that the United States has been funding will be abandoned, you know, that these Navy ships that we can no longer afford to pay for, and that all the people who are loyal to not the United States but to the dollar paychecks that they were receiving for their servitude will end. The corporate powers, the Google power, the Apple power of the latest, coolest, hippest iPhone will no longer matter. The stock traders, the lawyers, the politicians, the celebrities, the basketball players, all of it that we, you know, pop stars, they'll all be worth nothing. We won't even care about them. But I tell you what, there'll be a shift in consciousness to things that will matter. You know, the people who do create food, the people who do provide care for people, the real tangible things like gold and silver, the real friends that would, you know, they don't care about, you know, what you do or what you drive, but who you are and actually care. Those are the things that will matter. And power is going to devolve down to the most local and responsive level. And I'm telling people, start looking around at where you are. If you are in any city, get out now while you still can. Move to the boring parts of the country. Get with real friends that actually care about who you are, not what you do. Start getting your money. Not start getting money. Get your money out of the banking system, the stock market, the pensions, the 401ks. They're all digital illusions that the moment that you need it won't be there. We saw that in 2008. You saw that the limit withdrawals, though, the price of what you bought it for is half or a third of what it was. Be prepared for this, because this is the only thing that will matter in this person's lifetime, what you did before and where you'll be after.
The Silver Shield Exchange is a free weekly podcast, but the only way to hear it is through email. Sign up today at silvershieldexchange.com.